Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com Page 2 Busy Signal The Modern Music Producer's Guide to Making Money Online The Three Pillars of Power Chapter 1, Traffic, 8 The New Way of Marketing, 8 How to Reach the Right People, 9 But How Do You Reach Your People, 12 How to Generate Traffic for Free with Content, 15 How to Use Leverage to Generate Traffic, 19 Modern Ways of Utilizing Traffic, Email, Text Lists, 21 How to Build Momentum with Traffic, 28 How to Monetize Traffic, 31 Why Traffic Needs to be Filtered, Qualifying Traffic, 36 Traffic at Low Cost, Traffic at High Cost, 39 Vanity Metrics, 43 Audience Retention, 46 Quality vs Quantity, 50 When to Pitch, 52 Chapter 2, Value Exchange, 56 Value Exchange Defined, 56 The Shepherd's Gate, 63 Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com Page 3 The Three Motivations, 67 Inspiration vs Motivation, 69 The End Goal, 73 The Win-Win-Win, 75 Free vs Paid, 77 Never Leave Without the Contact, 80 Investment, Return on Time, 81 Solve Problems or Spike Good Feelings, 84 The Hidden Values, Lording, Status, End Goals, etc. 87 How to Find the Value, 91 Estimated Value, Stock Prices, 92 Utility Value, 95 Chapter 3, Relationships, 96 What is Relationship, 98 How to Build New Relationships, 101 Events, 103 Value Add, 107 Touch Points, 108 Building Trust Currency, 111 Introductions, 113 Keeping It Alive, 116 When to Ask Favors, 119 Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com Page 4 How to Ask for Favors, 120 Symbiotic Relationships, 121 Leech Relationships, 122 Communication Level Expectations, 123 Access and Levels, Boundaries Based on Contact, .124 Final Words, 127 Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com Page 5 Who the Heck Am I? I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. I've trained over 800,000 producers around the world who have gone to work with Drake, Kanye West, J. Cole, Lil Baby, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, NBA Youngboy, Trippy Red, Young Thug, YG, Polo G, French Montana, Ray Schrammerd, and many more artists on the Billboard charts. I've also worked alongside top audio companies like Universal Audio, Isotope, ImageLine, Arturia, Sweetwater, Waves, Razer, Gaming Laptops, and more. This book is for you. This book is for the modern music producer who is forging a path towards their destiny. It is for the people who understand their inner phoenix energy, the spirit which rises from the ashes over and over again. This book is for the warrior who leaped off the boat onto shore, only to burn the very boat behind him because he busy signal BusyWorksBeats.com Page 6 believed in himself so much he knew retreating was not an option. This book is for those who are dedicated and obsessed with their vision. This book is for those looking for a real alternative to the ancient music industry. This is for those who are fed up with the way larger companies do business with the small guys and take advantage of them. This is for those who will take action. Who it's not for this book is not for those who are looking at music like a lottery. This book is not for those who are skeptical about funnels or demonize marketers online. This book is not for those who think marketing takes away from their music. This book is not for those who want to work for the traditional music industry. This book is not for those who think they know it all. Why you should keep reading? You should continue with this book for one reason: to multiply your music business at light speed and to grow beyond belief. This book will illustrate the modern methods of doing business within the music business. This book will illuminate the unseen busy signal BusyWorksBeats.com Page 7 Opportunities within a dying industry that is resurrecting into new beginnings. After training over 800,000 producers around the world, I've learned how to stay on the cutting edge of music production. With over 100 million views from In the Trenches work and experience on YouTube, I've come to find many keys to success in the new music business. Even after making over 3,600 free videos, I'm still learning how to stay on the forefront of the business. This book will give you a 20-year head start. You may be asking, how will it give me a 20-year head start if you've only been in business for 5 years? It's because I've learned from mentors who shortcut my process by 10 years and I've influenced close to a millennium in time, over 970 years of influence with content. I want you to have the same results I've created in 5 years' time with no blueprint in front of me. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 8. 3 pillars of power. Power is work over time. You either increase your workforce by employing a ton of people or leverage others, or you reduce time. Game, BusyWorkSpeeds.com chapter 1, traffic. The world is converting from the physical world to the digital world. Game, BusyWorkSpeeds.com. The new way of marketing. The first priority in running your new music business is bringing in people. Long gone are the days of posting flyers to local community walls, hosting small get-togethers with vendors, and holding signs by the side of the road. We are in a global economy now. This means the people you want to do business with are not necessarily in your town. You must use other means to contact your potential customers. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 9. If you want to stay small, think local. If you want to grow bigger, think global. Now that you know you have to search outside of your small town, the question now becomes, how do I reach the people I want? How to reach the right people? You must first understand the virtual construct of the world. Just like you have cars driving down your highway, you have people jumping from website to website. Your neighborhood residents are equivalent to a social media profile, it's their home online. Mailboxes are now email boxes. Brick and mortar physical stores are now converting to websites or website-driven businesses. Calculators, Rolodexes, dial phones, word processor machines, whiteout, paper, video cameras are all now in one device which runs on software. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 10. We are converting our physical world into the digital world and the race is for power and control over the new virtual world. The question is, when will you plant your stake in the ground? The new music business gives you full control over your relationship with your customer. In the old music business, there were too many middlemen. You, the music creator, would sign to a record label which handled the shipping and logistics. That record label would then use their network of distributors, people who get your product in front of customers, to distribute your product to the customers. This old system had two middlemen, the record label and the distributor. This meant that your communication wasn't really under your control, as the middlemen could skew that communication and potentially lose your connection with your customer. This old system got shattered and disrupted by streaming platforms. The reason streaming platforms transformed the music industry is because they cut out the middleman called the record label. Now, Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 11. Music artists can go directly to distributors, people who get your product in front of customers, and get their product into the world near instantly. However, the new music business is more advanced than streaming platforms. The issue with most streaming platforms is that you don't know who streamed your song and you can't contact them directly. The streaming platforms understand this power, hence them holding it back from you. The power is in the direct communication with your customer. The power is in controlling the distribution. In the ancient times, people flocked to the Roman Colosseum to watch gladiators fight to the death. The gladiators got all the attention, the same way people with social media accounts get all the attention. The problem is, the cost of that attention was death and the lifetime of that attention was short-lived. The king and queen held the real power and they sat in the stands of the Colosseum. The king and the queen didn't stand in the middle of the Colosseum and fight for attention, they directed the attention to Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 12. The gladiators and could do so forever without working hard or risking death. The true power is in directing attention, not being the focus of attention. This is how you can use leverage, one thing accounting for many, to build your empire without working harder. But how do you reach your people? Now that you understand the new way of doing business, we can now talk about how to attract and find your customers. You must start with the question, where do my people live online? If you think of the virtual world like the physical world, you will see that people hang out in certain areas. In the old days, if you wanted to find a biker with lots of leather, you would check the local dive bar, which had all the motorcycles lined up near the entry. If you wanted to find a conservative-minded man, you would check the local church. If you wanted to find dogs, you would head to the local dog park. If you wanted to find singers, you would visit the music studio. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 13. Online is the exact same principle, the only difference is people gather in different places, even while having the same interest. Just like every person who loves basketball doesn't go to the same court. The good news is that online activity has become hyper-focused and less spread across many websites. This makes it easier to find your audience. The principle is that people with common interests congregate in the same locations. You can use this understanding to go find your audience. What interests, outside of music, do your people have? Are they into hypebeast culture? Do they like a special type of cooking? Do they follow a specific TV series? Are they into music production, audio engineering, recording, or mixing? Do they enjoy a certain celebrity? Are they into certain clothing brands? Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 14. Music is too general of an interest. Genre is too general of an interest. Why? Because it will cost you lots of money to advertise and market to all of one genre or to everyone who likes music. It is too vague. Everyone who likes hip-hop doesn't like Tyler, the Creator. The same way everyone who likes music doesn't like Kanye. Leave the broad interests for the companies with $100 million to spend. For you, you have to narrow down who you want to attract. You can do this by finding an interest outside of genre and outside of music. This will give you the idea of a subculture within music. For example, underground hip-hop is a subculture. People who like to perform beats only using underground hip-hop is a subculture within a subculture. The further you narrow, the less you'll spend and the more accurate your product match will be. Marketing is about matching people with what they want and what you can deliver to them to fulfill that desire. Instead of guessing who may like something, you can start by asking who likes that thing and work backwards to find them. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 15. Once you know the interests outside of music and genre, you can then start scouting the influencers and companies associated with that interest. If you're targeting a skater, you may want to think about brands like DGK, Birdhouse, Baker, Skate, and Destroy, Plan B and more. You take the brands people already love and use their cultural language, cultural norms, and create content around this while mentioning your product. If you want to be really smart about it, you would create a product specifically for that customer profile. Attaching your music to a greater experience like stickers or producing skate videos with your music behind it. You have to be creative, and once you narrow down into who you're actually talking to, you will have ideas flying by because your customer is clearly defined. How to generate traffic for free with content? Lots of producers think running ads is the magical solution to traffic. If it were that easy, everyone with a dollar would be doing it. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 16. Traffic goes deeper than paid ads. You have to earn real respect to build relationships with your customers. The same way you can't pay your way into a friend group, you can't pay your way into business. I've created over 3,000 free videos for YouTube to help build respect and trust with producers around the world. I had to show producers I would give my all to serve them. In return, they showed love and I earned my respect with them. I've spent money on ads, I've withheld money from ads, all still earning a profit. Ads are for scaling. Scaling is when you find something working and want to pour gasoline on it. You have to make sure something works first. This past month, I've spent little to none on ads and had the greatest month in the history of my business, in terms of profit. Ads aren't always the answer. There are people making $1 million per month but spending $999,500 on ads only to make a profit of $500. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 17. In short, don't get confused by people reporting revenue, because chances are, they spend a lot of money to earn that money, which means their true net profit is lower than the big number. That's usually always the case. When you make content, you are leveraging billion-dollar infrastructures of huge companies to get your message out for free. I've had memes get millions of views on Facebook, all for free. Those same views in paid ads would cost near $50,000. Once you understand the value of reach, you won't squander it anymore. Content ranges across the current social media platforms. TikTok utilizes vertical video with short length. Twitter utilizes short video but mostly text. Instagram utilizes photo and short length video. YouTube utilizes short to long form video. Facebook utilizes all of the above. When you're creating content, you have to start with the result you want your audience to take. Making videos for video's sake will only leave you drained. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 18. What is the result you want? Do you want people to buy your thing? Do you want people to visit your song? Do you want people to subscribe? One piece of content rarely does all of the above. When you focus on a result you want, you can map out the content making process a lot easier. One thing you have to understand is separating content from sales offers. In the beginning, you have to test a lot of variations until you find what works. I've trained many people and I see how little they test. Every YouTube video is a test. You test the headline, title of the video, you test the thumbnail, image of the video, and you test the content within the video. Only producing one video per week will not give you enough results to even see what works. You have to produce lots of content until you find trends and commonalities in the results with your social content. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 19. Instead of being a user of social media, be a producer on social media. Yes, there are lots of algorithm changes and you may not directly be monetized on a platform, but the goal is to get people to know you, like you, then trust you. In order to do this, you have to get in front of them constantly. Understand that each platform has its own culture, so simply blasting your content across each platform may not work. You'll have to create content specifically for each platform. But only do this until you see the top two platforms where you get results. Pumping out content where you get no results is a waste of time. How to use leverage to generate traffic? If you're smart, you will work less. Find friends who create similar value as you and team up to give away free things to your audience. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 20. For example, we released a power pack for producers around the world in response to the pandemic of 2020. I wasn't the only one contributing to the pack, I asked all my friends who make sounds to contribute. We gathered over 20 different contributions from my friends and I used that compiled package to send it to producers in need. Not only was the power pack more enticing because it had much cooler stuff in it, but it also meant I didn't have to work as hard to create a package for the community. This is how you have to think when creating lead magnets, things you use to get people to sign up to email or text lists, and when creating content. How can you use something someone else created to help ease the process of making content from scratch? What does your audience want for free that you can provide? What does your audience want for free that your friends can provide? Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 21. What does your audience want for free that your audience can provide? With your traffic machine rolling, the question now becomes, how do you use the traffic for the benefit of your business? Modern ways of utilizing traffic, email, text lists, modern music production marketing is not only about getting people's attention, it's about taking their attention and directing it elsewhere. The main problem with social media is that your marketing message to your audience gets drowned out by tons of competition. When you post a YouTube video, your audience is distracted by the ad in the front of the video, the videos in the sidebar, and the videos which play automatically after your own. Imagine you spent all your time, money, and energy courting a busy signal. BusyWorksBeats.com page 22. Newly found woman and then brought her into an event with nothing but wealthy single NBA players. Your chances of keeping that woman's attention will lower because she is placed directly in front of your competition. Just as that sounds foolish, why would you do the same in business? Unless you found a magical unicorn who doesn't care about the celebrity effect or wealth, then the above example may not directly apply. But for 99.9% of the cases, it will distract the woman naturally and biologically because women are hardwired to be attracted to men with resources, as they can use those resources to provide for their children and protect them. So, what is my point? My point is that you don't want to expend all your energy and time placing your customers directly in front of your competition. That's why you need to convert your traffic into a place where you can have a one-on-one connection with your audience without distraction. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 23. Email lists were thought to have died. That is not the case. Email is the primary revenue generator for most online businesses. My theory, which is not based on any science, is that people aren't in buy mode when watching social media content, they just want to be entertained and educated. People opening mail, however, are more conditioned to buy because we don't normally consume information through mail. Magazines and newsletters were big before the internet, but even these content pieces entertained or educated. Only when someone saw an ad would they think of buying. When you think of mail, you think bills, student loan consolidation offers and terrible newspaper coupons. You don't think, boy, I can't wait to open my mail to read about the Shakespearean period of the 1500s. Since we're conditioned for mail to be so money-based, we associate exchanging money with mail. Whereas, watching TV, we don't think of spending money, only indirectly through branding. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 24. These core mindsets are the main philosophy as to why email is for money making. I know there are exceptions to the rule and outliers. But most producers reading this right now have not fully tapped into proper email marketing. To keep it simple, here's what you'll need: 1. Email autoresponder program. 2. Text marketing platform. There are differences between email autoresponders. Some have better delivery rates, meaning people actually get the email when you send it and it's not sent to spam. While others have better integrations with your e-commerce software and social media ad platforms. Ultimately, you'll upgrade and move around over time, so don't spend a week trying to pick the best one. I'm not sure the year you'll read this book, but technology moves so fast, I don't want to recommend a specific provider because it may be obsolete in 5 years. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 25. But I've heard good things about ActiveCampaign, smiley face. As of June 2020, text marketing seems extremely intimate. I think text marketing is great for having conversations, but I don't think it's great for selling. When's the last time you got a sales offer in your text and actually responded to it? It seems like a breach of privacy. Who would ever want their text inbox to say 300 unread texts? That would make life so annoying and frustrating. Then, we humans would have to create a new way of communicating with our loved ones. I just don't see text blowing up. That's from my lens. I do see it as a great tool to talk to people, but I don't see it as a great tool to sell. Now, I have seen text marketing used for live events. The live speakers would be on stage and they would say text live event to 555-5555. Then, everyone in the crowd would take pictures of the screen and all text the number. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 26. Later, after the presentation, the speaker would say thank you in the text, using mass broadcasting, and later offer them access to a limited time event, another event completely, or some high-level coaching they were doing. It felt super cheesy and gimmicky to me. I quickly unsubscribed from the text marketing because they would text me randomly. I felt like the text marketing worked while I was with the speaker, but when I went home away from the speaker, it had no effect. I'm a big believer in being an early adopter of new technology, but I am also a big believer in common sense and user experience. To me, text is extremely intimate. And to interrupt someone's life just to get off a sale seems like more of a risk than a reward. With all that said, there are strategic ways you can use text. Currently, I use text to verify access and confirm things or get reminders. I could see text being used not as a primary broadcasting medium but a component within your funnels and systems to remind people they forgot something in the cart, or busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 27 remind people of a live event or something they scheduled with you. Other than those functions, tread lightly with text marketing because you want to think how you would feel if someone kept marketing to your text. It's like the guy who constantly leaves audio messages because they want to force you to open the text because they know you can't read it and ignore the message. Always remember, your traffic sources will vary, so don't put so much stock into one platform/medium. You want to be spread but also want to understand the style of communication on each medium. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 28 How to build momentum with traffic. If you want to 10x your traffic, you have to get the most out of one viewer. I can take $1 and buy an apple. I can also take my credit card and buy an apple for $1, immediately use my cash $1 to pay that credit card bill while earning points from my credit card. Instead of only getting an apple with $1, I can leverage a credit card to get more for that same $1. There are more financial instruments you can use to maximize that dollar even further, but this is not a book on finance, nor financial or legal advice. Please advise your accountant or lawyer with fiduciary responsibility. Social media traffic is the same as $1. You can either send people from your YouTube directly to your website or send people from your YouTube to your YouTube playlist series, which directs people to your Instagram page. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 29 That turns one viewer into three actions. The key is retaining their attention long enough to help them complete these actions. The following example is hypothetical and I am not giving any financial or legal advice. Please advise your accountant or lawyer with fiduciary responsibility. If I had $1,000 cash and wanted to build trust and a financial relationship with my friends in business, I would take that cash and move it. I would borrow $1,000 from my friend A. Friend A may be a bit resistant to give me $1,000 with no context. I would use my $1,000 cash as collateral or a guarantee to them that if I did lose their money, they could take my initial $1,000 as a replacement of their $1,000. I now have $2,000 cash, $1,000 more than I had before. I can use this money to invest. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 30 Then, I would ask my friend B for $1,000 as well, using friend A's money as collateral instead of my own cash. This is leverage, using other people's money to get more money. I now have $3,000 cash even though I only had $1,000 and I'm only risking my $1,000 cash. I would take friend B's money and pay friend A back his $1,000 loan to me. Friend A would now trust me with their money and consider lending me more in the future. I would take my initial $1,000 in cash and pay friend B. They would both be paid back in full without ever losing a dollar. The faster I pay them back, the better. I'm using this example because it shows the power of moving money. The same way you need to think about moving your traffic. Your traffic is your $1,000 in this case. If you want to create massive momentum, you need to create deals with other creators. Busy Signal BusyWorkSpeeds.com page 31 who already have an audience and use the above example to build trust with them to later ask for more exposure or favors. How to monetize traffic. The biggest mistake I see content creators making is thinking that it's a sin to sell anything to their audience. If you believe in your product or service and believe it will change the life of your audience, you are being selfish not to offer it to them. If you were thirsty and dehydrated and I had your best interest at heart, knowing I had 40 cases of water in my garage, if I never offered you a bottle of water, I would not be a friend at all. It is selfish not to offer your audience who has needs. The problem most people have is not having enough views and watch time to be eligible for social media monetization partnership. This is why affiliate marketing and brand deals are so powerful. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 32. With affiliate marketing, it doesn't matter how many views you get on a video, it's all based on how many people who watched went to purchase the product. If you have 100 views and 10 people purchased a product valued at $100 and you get a 10% commission, you now have $100. That is equivalent to $1 per view. That's insane. Now compare that to the YouTube average of $1 per 1,000 views. Sounds insane, right? You'd have to work 1,000x harder to get the same dollar. That's why I created an agency focused specifically on artist/producer content creators. My goal is to link you up with deals and get you earning faster. From brand deals, to sponsorships, to affiliate deals, my goal is to accelerate your business and get you the deal flow you deserve. People ask me about placements a lot. I ask them this in return. What is a Drake placement to Drake? Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 33. Drake's version of a placement is to work with top brands like Nike, apparel companies, liquor companies, and more. That is a placement to Drake. I'm sure Drake is not chasing a Rich the Kid placement in order to get paid. You have to shift your mindset to understand the bigger game of business. Music business is much bigger than just music. It's headphones, it's live conferences, it's tech companies, it's ad campaigns, it's retail stores and customer experience. Music fuels the world of commerce and drama. I'm simply showing you the greater game. That is my job in creating deal flow for you. My agency is based on real experience as a producer. I know what it feels like to sit with a hot laptop on my laptop during the height of the summer, struggling to find a way in the world. I remember feeling like the ceiling of the room was the ceiling to my life. I know what it's like to try and rank on the SoundClick charts and fight for YouTube video placement. I've seen the culture shift from brass to guitar. I've been in the Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 34 trenches with you, and now I have the opportunity to speed up your process so you can avoid all the mistakes I made along the way. Most people screw up their social media content because they blatantly sell. Think of dating. Would a girl really think you have swag if you just say, "Hey, I want to sleep with you right now"? No, she'll probably laugh in your face and call you lame because you didn't have any style in your approach. But, if you used innuendos and subtle suggestions which didn't make you seem so desperate in wanting it, you would get a much greater response. People respond negatively to desperation, but people love when people don't need them. Sounds crazy, but if you beg for money, you won't get any. If you act like you don't need someone's money, they will be so curious as to why you have so much confidence in yourself and want to give you some. It's a weird thing about life. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 35. It's much more effective to start off backed by the companies you trust than going in with no allies. Wouldn't you love to be on a team of content creators just like you, who all have connections with the best companies in the business? All while getting paid for product placements, brand sponsorships, affiliate deals, and your own products. I only want to work with people who believe they can do better than me. I currently have over 100 million views on YouTube alone, after deleting 3-10 million views, and over 3,000 videos with over 900 years of influence. If you are willing to work like me and put your heart and soul into your passion, then I want to see you on my team. If not, don't even bother submitting an application. We don't want D players, we want the A players. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 36. Why traffic needs to be filtered. Qualifying traffic. One huge mistake producers make is not qualifying their audience and thinking that everyone will find their stuff valuable. You'll waste more time and energy not qualifying your audience. Let's make a dating example. If you want a wife with good morals and family values, you need to filter out the types of girls most likely to fit that image. If you were foolish enough to go to the local dive bar, EDM festival, or nightclub to find a wife with good morals and family values, you would have much lower odds of finding her in those places. The issue most producers have is trying to attract everyone for a solution that only a few need. You want to weed out the people you don't want immediately. Or else, you'll spend tons of money on ads, compile lists and audiences which don't match the buyers, and stockpile junk contacts which won't ever do business with you. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 37. Every time I see a frustrated salesman talk about the customer after they leave, saying they wasted my time and didn't even buy anything, I always ask them, did you qualify the customer coming in the store? Qualifying comes down to two types of people: people with the money to buy who want to buy, and people without the money and interest. If you don't screen people to see if they have the interest in what you offer and make sure that they have the money to actually make that purchase, you are spending time and energy on people who can't ever give you what you want. It's like spending an entire day planting and watering seeds that you planted in unfertile soil. The plants won't grow no matter how much fertilizer and water you dump onto the seeds, because the ground doesn't have the sufficient nutrients to even fuel the idea of the seed. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 38. Lack of filtering is why you keep experiencing bad customers, refunds, lack of sales, failed romantic relationships, failed business relationships, failed investments, and more. Filtering and knowing what to focus on is the key to marketing. Marketing is simply matching your product or service with the correct audience. You're simply connecting two points which want to come together. If you're trying to match a triangle with a square, it won't work no matter how hard you try. It's fundamentally flawed. It's easier to know the shapes and know to filter out all the shapes which aren't squares if you wanted to match a square with another square. You filter your mail. You filter your emails. You filter your clothes. You filter your groceries. You filter your music project files, but you refuse to filter out the very people willing to support your lifestyle. Sounds insane, because it is. So stop being lazy and get more targeted as to who you want to serve and who your solution actually applies to. Traffic at low cost, traffic at high cost. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 39. Traffic can be free, but it can also come at a cost. You may be able to stimulate 30,000 views per day, but you can generate 300,000 views per day using additional paid traffic. The best traffic source is traffic that was nurtured by you. These would be the people who love you and love what you do. The second best traffic source is endorsed traffic, traffic which is sent from an already trusted source or person. The third best traffic is organically earned traffic through your sales of product or service. The fourth best traffic is organically earned through your social media content. That fifth best traffic is paid content to people who have interacted with your content at some point. The last style of traffic is completely cold. These are people who are not aware of you or your brand and come in contact with your Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 40, Stuff Viaduct paid ads. They may have a common interest but are not familiar with you. How many people from the above categories do you actually talk to on a daily basis? Instead of paying $6 for a customer using Facebook, you can link up with an already trusted source or person and pay them $3 per customer. You instantly just earned 50% on your ad budget and gained endorsed traffic. But how would you buy traffic from someone else? You can do this in various ways. You can buy media or ad space. This is the old-fashioned way of finding people with a sizable audience who may need your product or service, and paying the owner of the website or brand to post something about you. It could be an ad banner, a quick shout-out, a link, etc. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 41. Another way of buying traffic from other businesses is to offer an affiliate commission for every purchase they earn through their content. You would split the earnings with that creator. In this case, it only costs you if they make the sale. But I'd rather pay a real creator who I can build a relationship with than a soulless corporation. You can also leverage free to get traffic for low cost. Let's use some examples. Back in 2013, Jay-Z struck a deal with Samsung to release his album 3 days earlier to anyone who bought a Samsung phone. These are not all the details of the deal, but the idea was that Jay-Z would sell copies of his album to Samsung so they could give them away for free to owners of certain Samsung phones. Not only was Jay-Z paid for the copies of the album, he was placed in front of at least 1 million Samsung users. This means, Jay-Z gains access to his potential target audience for the price that it costs Samsung to acquire a customer. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 42. So for example, instead of Jay-Z paying $6 per customer to reach the same customer that Samsung had, he could leverage Samsung only paying $3 for that same customer. He gets in front of the same people for less. This is the key behind joint ventures. Even if Jay-Z had to pay to work with Samsung or share earnings from the album, he still would be getting traffic at a lower cost than just plain advertising. That's the power of leverage, endorsed traffic, and joint ventures. Why spend more money than you have to get in front of the same person? Joint ventures are not just ways to give away your income, they are strategic ways to handle competition. I'd rather collaborate with my competitor than for us to both waste tons of money fighting for the same customer. We can both benefit rather than both lose. Keep in mind, joint ventures are not the same as a mutually benefiting campaign. Joint ventures involved splitting the pie over time and tying brands together. It can involve paperwork around using the other's likeness, etc. Just keep in mind when working Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 43 with other companies, they're not so easy to throw around the titles joint venture or partnership. Vanity metrics. The modern world is built on vanity. We act out for likes and do savage things for followers and retweets. All which don't matter in the grand scheme of business. I want you to completely throw out your illusion of social media. What if I told you business still goes on without you posting or replying? That's what can be a reality once you build your business the proper way. I don't necessarily have to post to earn money. It helps keep things fresh, but it's not required. It's a matter of helping growth, not necessarily the finances. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 44. Don't worry about like ratios. There are plenty of videos with more dislikes than likes which have more views than both our channels combined. Don't worry about everyone's comment because everyone is not your customer. Don't worry about views because views don't directly equal money, and SEO and metadata only help after you post. Where was the SEO when Tekashi69 posted his video which goes millions of plays in minutes? How would SEO help that? It didn't. The demand was high before he even posted the video. There are two ways to get traffic: if people search for you and if you interrupt them somewhere. SEO helps only when people are searching for you. It's called search engine optimization. But if people aren't searching for your video or title, you have to create demand through other machines than the social media platform at hand. When I realized that most models on Instagram bought likes, live stream viewers, and comments, I used to think they had some Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 45 magical power to generate attention. Nope. They just spent $50 and got fake stats so that they could fake out influencer agencies who went on to trick their business customers advertising the number of followers channels had. I know companies that won't work with people below a certain follower count. I find that so backwards. If only they understood how people fake a following to get the deals. The even bigger problem is when these companies find out that the influencers aren't very influential at all. Then, they never come back and do business with the influencer. That's why I've made it a point to not focus on followers. I look at the culture. I look at how people respect you. I look at the quality of your work and if people find it truly valuable. My agency is based on real results, not fluff. Because I can see through the vanity metrics. I'm in the trenches. I know who's respected and who's not. My agency doesn't focus on building vanity metrics, we build real results, real respect, and real value. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 46. Audience retention. I mentioned the value of keeping or retaining your audience. The key to keeping people's attention is not just for the sake of having attention. You must make sure you're redirecting their attention, similar to the friend A, friend B analogy on page 12. Gladiators used to fight to the death in the Roman Colosseum. They had stadiums full of people watching them brawl. They got all the attention, but someone wouldn't walk away alive. With every fight giving them 50% chance of survival, how long do you think a gladiator career would last? Not very long. My point is that attention is similar to a drug. Yeah, you'll get high, but that high will wear off over time and your body will become resistant to its effects. I don't want you to get high on attention because that's short-lived, I want you to direct the attention. This gives you true power because you can always replace the attention generator. This means you have access to infinite attention, even when one of your sources goes away. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 47. Just like my dollar example on page 12, how do you pass around the dollar? How do you pass around the attention? How can you leverage other people's attention atop your own? If you're going to do it for the clout, at least go big. If you meet one respected person, ask them to introduce you to their friends. And keep doing that over and over until your circle is huge with influential people. That's what I've done with my agency. I proved I could produce value with over 3,000 free videos on YouTube. I've proven I know how to get free traffic online with over 100 million YouTube views. I've earned the respect of the producers around the world because I put them first. And now, I've surrounded myself with the best of the best people who all influence the producer community in some fashion. I want a team of players in my agency. To keep your audience's attention, you have to challenge them daily and tell a story over time. You may think a story starts with once upon a time, but I want to reframe the definition of a story for you. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 48. A story is a sequence of if this, then that. So if you watch a young boy walk up to a girl he has a crush on and offer her a lollipop which wins her heart, you will internalize that story of if this, then that. You will believe that if you give a girl you crush on a lollipop she'll fall in love with you only because you internalized the story you watched. This is how Disney became a massive company, because they programmed all the kids with stories of if this, then that. This teaches us how to act even if we haven't experienced something in life. So by story I mean a sequence of showing people if this, then that, not necessarily once upon a time. Challenge your audience by giving them something they believe they can do. Make it something measurable so they can track their progress toward the goal. If you're really smart, you'll reward the people who achieve that goal. Fun marketing is really like creating a video game. In video games, you get a small high when you get a hit marker in Call of Duty and you get a rush when you complete your challenges to unlock a new skin for your weapon. But, you have to be able to measure your challenge and you can't make the challenge so hard that no busy signal busyworksbeats.com page 49 one will even try. Jumping 5 feet is believable, jumping from here to the moon is not believable, unlike your Elon Musk. Tell your people a story and show them that you, taking certain actions, lead to the results they already want. Show them new ways of taking action which leads to the goal or state they want to be in. Create a ritual for your people. This would be an event which occurs over time at a predictable and unchanging time. This creates trust that people can rely on your consistency. Call people by their name. When people are acknowledged, they are proud. When you work for an employer and they big you up, you feel great. Even though you don't plan on staying there for life, simply them acknowledging your hard work, softened your heart a bit. It's because we all want to be acknowledged and know we're appreciated for our hard work. I make that a staple in the way I interact with everyone. I make sure to credit everyone involved, even on the level of simple content. But this practice and discipline follows all the way up to my products. I want to acknowledge everyone and make them feel special because money can't keep busy. Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 50. People, making them feel special keeps people. That's why my agency is completely different from other agencies just looking for people with followers trying to milk your audience. I put you first and I believe acknowledging my team is the key. Quality vs. quantity. You will frequently hear the debate between quantity of product or quality of product. From experience, I've found that it takes quantity to know what your audience thinks is quality, and then when you have the quality, that takes you to the next level and you can mass produce the quality material. The worst thing you can do is assume you know what will work. One rule which will apply to all businesses is that you can only know through testing. This means you have to go through iterations until you find the solution which matches your hypothesis. You start with an educated guess and see if the results you're getting match your hypothesis. Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 51. Trust me, I've run many advertisements and you'd be surprised how the ads you think won't work, work the best. It's so bizarre, but when you're advertising you have to think in a completely different way than when you're creating with a knowing of what will work. In other words, you have to create a control. A control is the thing you measure against. So, if I wanted to test background colors of an ad, everything else must be the same. The only thing which may change is the background color. This will let us know from the results if people respond to red over orange or if they dislike green. When you're making advertisements, you have to keep everything the same except one thing. That one thing is what you're testing. You won't know the answer until it's given to you in testing. Then, when you have real results from real testing, you can make more general conclusions. The problem is, most modern media is infinitely creative, meaning it can have endless changes to test. Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 52. Quite literally, you won't know quality until you test the quantity. So always keep this in mind when you're making social media posts, creating ads, or recording videos. Everything is testing, so don't assume everything you'll do will result in huge numbers. Once you know what your audience wants and needs, you can double down on building quality products and services. Keep in mind, when you're running a real business, quality can come at a cost and you have to decide how much you're willing to invest in product quality. You're in business, not charity. When to pitch? Now that you know it takes quantity to get to quality, this opens up the question of when you should present your product or service to your audience. When do you pitch your product or service? Should you refrain from offering your products to save your algorithm momentum? Let's start with a better question. What is the intention of the social media platform in which you're posting your content? Their goal is to retain attention as long as possible to serve the user many ads, Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 53, so they can take stupid business owners' money. Their goal is to keep the cool kids in one place so everyone else will want to join. What's your goal when posting to social media platforms? To gain a following, build a relationship with your audience, and make money while serving them. If the social media's core intention is to keep people on the platform and your core intention is to eventually take them away, you will always be playing a balancing act of keeping people on without making the social media platform feel like you're not serving their intention. This seesaw will always be in effect. Your job is to figure out a balance of keeping people on the platform while still sending them to your website every now and again. To do this, you want to create a ratio of content and ask. I like to use simple ratios. There is no magic number because these companies change their algorithms almost daily because they have to fight against people trying to abuse it. There is no magical algorithm formula, so anyone telling you that is lying or fooling Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 54 themselves. They can only share the best practices they've learned while using the platform, which may not apply to you. Back to the ratio of content and ask. You can do the Gary V approach, which is jab jab hook, that's a 2-to-1 ratio. This means for every 3 pieces of content, you have 1 piece which mentions or alludes to your product or service. If you're into occult knowledge and ancient magical phenomenon like me, you would base your ratio on the golden ratio or phi. Using the ratio 1.618033988875:1. That's a little difficult to apply to content, so just multiply it by 10. That means for every 16 pieces of content, you'll have 10 offers. So, if you make 4 videos a week, you make 2 offers and a soft, less direct, offer. I usually do it on a greater scale. I'll do free series which don't mention any products, and then I'll do 5 videos straight where I do half content, half offer. You don't always have to be a robot about when you offer something. Just keep in mind, you need to balance keeping people on the platform, for enhancing the growth of your audience, and sending people to your website. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 55. I know some people who take the philosophy of doing only free content on their socials with no linking out and then using ads targeting people who have engaged with their channel. The only issue with this approach is that it costs you real money. Don't let not having tons of money dissuade you. My channel at BusyWorksBeats is outdoing companies with $50 million in funding. We're doing better than companies worth tens of millions. That's a sign you have more power than you think. Pick a ratio that you think works for you. Ultimately, your audience will let you know if you're too salesy or if they don't feel like your content is really content but sales pitches. There is a difference. I learned a long time ago, content is content and a sales offer is a sales offer. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 56 chapter 2. Value exchange. The key to a well-oiled business is the value exchange machine. Value exchange defined to understand business principles, it's much easier to use dating analogies. Let's put it this way, when you're trying to get the attention of a woman in order to date her, there is a step-by-step process. The first step in that process is getting her attention. The second step is showing her that you have value to exchange with her. Nobody wastes time on things which don't align with the things they value, even if the things don't have real intrinsic value. That's why you choose to watch football on a Sunday as opposed to picking up trash on the side of a major highway. It's because you value entertainment, avoiding the pain of your daily routine, and have a bond with the city's team because of how you were raised. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 57. If your core value was to save the world and prevent global warming, you may choose the second option with your time, to pick up trash on the side of a major highway. Your values lead to the actions you take. Whenever there is an exchange of energy, based on your perspective, you exchange for things you think are of value. Let's take it back to the getting a girl example. You meet a nice girl in the mall while shopping for a new book by Busy Worksbeats called Busy Signal. You peek over past the end cap of the business section labeled Music Business and see a young vibrant woman with a nice smile ordering an iced coffee from the indoor joint Starbucks. She catches your glance and smirks in your direction. Great, we've passed step one, getting her attention. Now, your job is to exchange value with this new girl. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 58. You walk up on her side American Samoa. She sits with her newly produced iced coffee and say, "Hey, what's your name?" She answers, and you begin your secret formula for talking to girls. You notice she's about to leave the Starbucks. What do? You exchange value. You stop her and ask for her contact information so you can continue your conversation, but you have to demonstrate a good reason as to why she should give you her most intimate mobile number. It's your job to exchange value at this point. Taking in all the environmental cues, you find her general interests are feeling smart, because why else would she get coffee in a conjoined bookstore? And you know she likes coffee because she's taken out her wallet and purchased one already. Your goal is to lead her to her real goal, to feel smart, intellectually engaged, and busy. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 59. Using the environmental cues, you know she wants to feel smart because she's in a bookstore, a place where your goal is to gain knowledge or be mentally engaged. Also a place where you buy books to feel secure in the case you need the knowledge to cover your mental weaknesses. So we can add that an underlying motivation of hers is security. This is a general motivation of all humans. Ordering iced coffee shows she wants to feel important or busy. Most people ordering coffee do so to feel upbeat so they can take on many tasks. And not only did she buy coffee, she bought it from Starbucks. Starbucks is a company known for its free Wi-Fi and upscale pricing. This is a key indicator that all patrons associate being busy or productive with the brand. Also, the pricing weeds out lots of people who just drink coffee to drink coffee. They figure, why spend the extra buck or two to be fancy? See how all these small cues can lead you to understanding her internal values. We also have to consider her perspective. She sees a guy in the business section labeled music business and smirks in your direction. That means she has taken cues from you without ever busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 60 engaging in conversation. That means, she's interested in someone who studies those things. Why would she visit a shopping mall just to walk in the bookstore and buy coffee? Maybe it's her favorite coffee spot because of other anchored events in her life which were pleasant. Maybe, she's lazy and that's the only Starbucks in the area within 3 miles of her place. Either way, you can take a lot of information from this fact. 1. Let's say she's had previous good experiences in that Starbucks. Why? Because she's engaged intellectually with someone in this place. That shows how strong of a pleasure she gains from this desire. Maybe she was with family and they took her to the coffee shop while Christmas shopping. Regardless of why the anchor exists, it exists. That means you can use the association to Starbucks in your favor. Use that as a cue to understand what she values. Ask her to talk over coffee again. Let's say it's the second scenario and she's just going there because of proximity. This shows us that Starbucks might not be busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 61 such a strong anchor but the indirect associations of shopping at Starbucks, prestige, feeling smart, feeling busy. Without even knowing the information you've gained in the conversation with said girl, we can extract tons of value. That's the power of listening and observing. Now, we have a game plan as to what to offer this girl. Always think best case and worst case. Not that you're being pessimistic but you always want to have a well, at least, offer because you want people to exchange with you, even if it's not the biggest sale in the beginning. So, before she heads out you ask for her contact because you want to share knowledge with her on what you've learned from all your reading over coffee at the same Starbucks. Not only does it keep it informal, it uses things already anchored into her mind. No need to fight the resistance in her mind to a new location. No need to convince her to like new subjects. You're using what's already there and adding value by reinforcing what the person already wants. You're just amplifying it. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 62 This will solve her already existing desires, to feel busy, to feel smart, and to show off that she can afford Starbucks. You're adding value to her because she gets to actualize her desires for even shopping at that Starbucks. You're solidifying the justification for her routine in life, making it feel important. You may have started this section of the book thinking you had to order a dozen roses and have a telegram sent to her house. Or even offering to buy her free coffee for the next week or a book from the store. No. Stop trying to force things onto her. She's already shown you what she values, just amplify the existing experience. Simple once you pay attention to all the details and it will save you the most money, smiley face. Always keep in mind, people do not necessarily care about you, they have their own self-interest. If you approached that girl with all the things you had in mind and she got nothing but wasted time busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 63 talking to a person she doesn't want to engage with, there would have been no exchange. Each party must walk away getting something they want or else they feel robbed in the exchange. The shepherd's gate think of your audience like sheep in a field. Not in a gullible sense but that your job is to protect them and guide them into success. When you gain their attention, you are drawing them into your big field, where your goal is to keep them there. Imagine you construct a fence separating the sheep from your side where you have premium food and cool treats they'd love. Once you draw in your audience with the free stuff where they occupy the field, the next step is to create the value exchange. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 64 In the middle of your fence, you create a gate with shears on both sides of the entrance. These shears will be used to cut off the edges of the sheep's coat so that you can collect wool for your clothing collection. Your goal is to get the sheep to come through your gate, get the edges of their coat sheared off, and into the other side of the fence. If you ran around the field with shears in your hand trying to forcibly cut each sheep, they would scatter and potentially leave the field entirely. That's called hard selling or forced approach. Instead of chasing each sheep down and wasting your energy forcing something on the sheep that they don't even want, you should create a value exchange at the gate entrance. What would entice the sheep to go from the free field over to your new premium side of the fence? Better food and more treats. You bang your cowbell and announce to the sheep you have new beef jerky on the other side of the fence. 10 of the 100 sheep busy signal busyworksbeats.com page 65 rushed toward the gate to get in, not even caring that their edges were sheared by the clippers in the gate entrance. They pass through sacrificing the edges of their coat and enjoy the surplus of beef jerky. 20 more sheep watch the 10 rush to the gate and observe because it piques their interest. They figure, if those sheep are having fun and liking that other side of the fence, it must not be that bad. So, they too, slowly approach the gate, maybe with a bit of caution, but they approach. The other 70 sheep don't pay the others any mind and go about enjoying the free grass in the field. Some veer off slowly walking into the gate, but in the total, only 40 end up on the other side of the fence. That's a 40% conversion rate. You successfully convinced 40 out of 100 sheep to enjoy your new food. In exchange, you got the wool from 40 sheep. They walk around a little lighter but full. And you have the wool you need to make your clothing. This is a win-win value exchange. Busy signal busyworksbeats.com page 66. It's that simple. Marketing is not complicated. The problem is when you only have a certain amount of space in the field and your gate can only take in one sheep at a time. The other side of the fence only has a certain amount of space, so what happens when 1,000 sheep arrive in your field? Can you handle all those sheep with only one gate? Even if all the sheep knew about the beef jerky, could they all get through the gate? You have to give your people what they already want. In exchange, you need to benefit from giving them what they want so you can continue to give them what they want. You're in business, not charity. Busy signal busyworksbeats.com page 67. The three motivations. If you know why a man acts, you can control the outcome game. Busyworksbeats.com. Humans are motivated by three main things: wealth, health, and relationships. This makes it simple to create messaging to your audience. Your goal is to help people reach their goal based on their core motivation. That's where the value exchange occurs. If I'm talking to a young and budding female artist based in Los Angeles and she values her figure and vegan diet, I know the conversations around how I can help her ultimately lead her to her health goals, even if it's within music. If you're trying to book studio time with her so you can invoice her label, you may use the P. Diddy approach and have her run around the studio to build her stamina before the session. That will tie in her natural desire to achieve health, and it also ties in her passion for music. You could add in a free smoothie during the visit or offer busy signal busyworksbeats.com page 68 to have DoorDash immediately when she arrives to order from the closest vegan spot. And while you're setting up the potential session, you can show her how powerful creative expression is to her mental health. You could use the biblical stories of how King Saul was calmed by stringed music, or you could show the science of how music calms anxiety. Either way, you're showing her how music ties into her health benefits. Instead of talking about how much money she could make if the record goes to number one, or how you can help her build tons of industry connections, you should focus on her core motivation for health. Messaging is all about catering to someone's motivation but wrapping your solution around it. Those three motivations are only the big bucket items. Those then segment into smaller interests. It's your job to decide one's big bucket motivation and their specific motivation pathway. This is done with data. You have to get to know your customer. Ask questions and observe deeply. You may think this will be easy, but you'll have to think deeper. Busy signal busyworksbeats.com page 69. If a man says he wants to buy a Ferrari sports car, do you think his motivation is wealth, health, or relationship? You may think his motivation is wealth because a high-priced sports car is like a trophy to a wealthy man, but what you don't understand is the layer beneath obtaining this trophy. The man actually wants to acquire this car because it signals he is wealthy to suitable mates. He actually wants the car not to obtain wealth, but to obtain and attract a mate. When learning how to sell and market to your audience, you will have to completely throw out your precepts and distorted realities. If you already knew it, you'd do it. But you don't know it. Always remember that. You don't know until you do. Inspiration versus motivation. No one likes to be forced or pushed into a sale. Motivation is pushing someone using force, whereas inspiring someone to make a decision pulls them toward their natural desire. Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 70. Does this mean motivation never works? No, but the majority of buyers aren't giving in to a pushy salesman, creating fake urgency and guilt if the buyer doesn't pay up. In life, we get motivated when things go wrong. We take the energy and try to show the world we're no one to play with. We turn that negative into positive, using it as motivation to create. Motivation only lasts for the lifetime of the stimulant. Once the annoyance or agitation is gone, so is the action. That's why inspiring someone to make a decision for themselves is much more powerful. People want to feel in control. What better way to allow them to feel in control than to inspire them to make a decision with their own brain, on their own time? Think about voting. We are inspired to change our conditions with a vote, but the choices were already made for us. Either this party or that party. What about all the other views and values in the country? They are not fully represented, so we don't have much of a choice at all. The illusion of choice is what makes us feel in control. The same goes for your customers. You want to lay out Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 71, options and allow them to choose, all while you determine both outcomes being in your favor. For example, I want a young lady to purchase my new BMW off the lot. I tell her she has two easy options: to drive this car off the lot today, to finance the car, or simply lease it and pay monthly for about 3 years. Both decisions are in the favor of the sale. I didn't tell her all the other options. I didn't say, you can also check the prices of a competitor, you can also go online and try to haggle another offer, you can also not buy the car at all. By creating the illusion of an option, I am allowing the customer to choose and feel empowered. This is the main reason we have price contrasts when we buy things. If you go to the McDonald's drive-thru and order a meal, it comes in multiple sizes. Those sizes are used to help you understand the value of the meal and also give you the power of choice. Without this, people feel like they are being sold to, rather than choosing to buy. If you need help translating this concept into your business, let me make it more simple. If your thing costs $50, I could tell the customer they have two main options: to pay in full now or pay $18. Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 72, for 3 months. The latter option will actually cost them a bit more, but giving them the illusion of control is key. You can even try this in your romantic relationships. If a girl wants her man to dress more classy, she can present two options: a suit and a business casual outfit from the closet. He will decide on his outfit for the evening by choosing from those two options. If she only had one outfit and asked him to wear it, he has a higher chance of resisting because it seems controlling that she wants him to change in some way, and he might rebel and wear something to embarrass them both at the dinner party. You can also apply this to your team. Give your team members and employees the option when rewarding them. Do you want a raise or paid time off? I did this with my team. We had a really spectacular quarter, and I asked my team members what they wanted individually to celebrate our win. Some said they wanted the bonus raise. Some suggested they wanted the time off. They were both the same thing, just presented as two separate options. The only difference is that the people who wanted the raise had to come back to work, whereas the people who took the paid time off, Busy Signal, BusyWorkSpeeds.com, page 73, didn't necessarily get a raise, they just didn't have to work. It's all in how we present things. The end goal, the ultimate goal for getting people's attention and gathering their contact information, is to serve them with your best and create a powerful culture of converts. You want to make your side of the fence look like a 24/7 party that makes everyone else wonder what they're doing with their time on the other boring side of the fence. If you aim to turn your customers into converts of culture, you will not need to spend tons of money on ads, because your customers will tell everyone for you and everyone will want to come into the club to join the fun. Your job is to show people they can trust you. The end goal is creating a customer who can trust your decisions. They are investing with you because you promised them a result, a moment. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 74 of Happiness with the Family, a placement, a career, peace, mastery of craft, etc. Imagine planting a seed on day one and expecting it to form into a full plant and bear fruit on day three. That's what most people do in their marketing. Nurturing your potential customer is like tending to a plant. You must first plant the seed into their mind about your service or product. You then water the seed with content and trust-building demonstrations. You weed out doubts and objections along the way. And over time, the seed will turn into a nice healthy plant. If you're hungry now, harvest plants which are already nurtured. In other words, go where people already built up trust with their audience and made content for them. Come in with your offer and harvest from someone else's hard work. It's called goodwill in the business world. Lots of content creators build up goodwill with their audience over time, which later gets monetized by brands and other partnerships. The issue with only aiming to eat now is that if you don't plant seeds and all the fully bloomed plants are gone, you have nothing. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 75 to eat. So marketing and business is a balance between eating now and waiting until later. The win-win-win. You don't want your audience to feel as though exchanging with you is a huge cost to them. They shouldn't feel drained or feel the effects of buyer's remorse. To prevent this, we want the audience to feel like they're winning in the exchange. They are getting more of a benefit from interacting with you than not. The secret is that you can take it one notch higher. You can use other people's stuff and give that away for free. It's a win for them because they get their name out to tons of new people. It's a win for you because you now have a contact you can busy signal. BusyWorksBeats.com, page 76, talk to over time for potential business. And it's a win for the person exchanging contact information because they get something of value for free. The win-win-win approach is about mastering leverage. If you've ever sound designed before, you know how long it can take to come up with good sounds. What if someone already had a pack? And you collabed with them to give their pack away for free to your potential audience while you collected emails. It's been done countless times. The key is being the one with the leverage. In every business dealing, try focusing on the win-win-win. The best business I've ever done was between people who both walked away happy. This industry is not like cold cutthroat businesses where people have to negotiate or die. It's a new world with much more flexibility. If business makes you feel bad, you should have the power to walk away. That's leverage. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 77. How can you let your audience walk away feeling like the winner? How can you offer something someone else already made? What benefit do people get for exchanging their contact information with you? What do people already want that you can offer for free? Free vs paid. When people come in first contact with you, you can either have a paid value exchange or a free value exchange. When you go to the grocery store, are the chips free? Or do you have to buy the chips to find out if you like them? Free is only a marketing technique, it's not mandatory. This has been used in modern marketing campaigns as well. Entrepreneurs offer their new book for free, you just pay the shipping. In other words, hey, here's my book, you'll pay a flat shipping fee that's inflated, which basically covers the cost of making the book, and you'll pay the actual shipping fee. Even if the price didn't include the cost of the book, you are still paying to get something and paying to exchange value. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 78. The point of the value exchange is to show other people you can deliver on your marketing promises. It doesn't matter if that's in the form of a free webinar or a $99 seminar in a hotel where you pitch them on the real product anyway. The point of the value exchange is to filter your audience. The goal is to gather people with a common interest and weed out who will be a buyer and who won't. The goal of the value exchange is to get their foot in the door so they can try you out. I think most of us get confused because we don't have physical products which cost money to manufacture and ship. Without these hard costs, you don't think outside the box when creating offers people can bite into. Always keep in mind the two types of customers, the affluent and everyone else. You can easily offend the affluent by offering a discount or giving them something for free because they may reply, "Oh what, you don't think I can afford that?" Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 79. That's happened to me in Macy's during Christmas time. The lady heavily insisted that I use all these coupons and discounts, and I think she even handed me some scissors to cut out coupons from the catalog book. I refused and said I'm paying full price. Why? Because it was insulting to waste time over a small discount amount. I wanted to reinforce that if I want something, I can get it. I don't need handouts or charity. If I want something, I should pay the price of sacrifice for it. So giving into those discounts would have counteracted my beliefs at that time. I also didn't want my motivation to be the fact that I was getting X percent off. This would lead me to only buy things because they were X percent off whether I actually wanted them or not. I didn't want to be a slave to a discount sticker. That is why it's so critical you understand who you're talking to when you're marketing your products and services. Never leave without the contact. Back in my heyday, I used to go to a lot of college parties. We would study all week from morning to evening, and when the weekend hit, we would go out to have fun. I learned a huge Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 80 lesson while partying, and that is, to never leave without the contact. Most guys go out to drink with their friends and meet girls. That's the basic motivation for men who go out to college functions. I too, was a basic male. Smiley face. When I arrived to the frat parties in the same plaid party shirt, I kept the same goal, get numbers. Why was getting numbers so important to me? Wouldn't you just want to wild out and leave with girls the same night? For me, the answer was no, and that's because subconsciously I was seeking a solid long-term relationship. I just didn't know where to find my girl. My goal was to get numbers because at parties, you don't know people. It's not ideal to pull up someone's social media while you're dancing and in the moment. Sometimes, you meet people and have no idea what their name is or where they go to school. To avoid never seeing them again, you have to create a point of Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 81 contact. This is why getting the number was so important. What's the point of leaving the party with a girl, if you didn't know her name, where she went to school, or how to find her again? It seemed pointless to me. Getting the contact is the most important goal for the night, if you're aiming to build relationships and longevity with results. Anyone can get lucky one night, but what's the point if you can't repeat the results? Always get the contact. It's your way of following up with someone to learn more about them or to meet again for a chance to exchange value. Investment. Return on time. Most people only measure their return on investment in the form of money. I like to measure the cost of time as well as money because time I cannot get back. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 82. The biggest mistake I see creatives making when they first start is charging extremely low prices for work which took them hours. Think about it. If you sell your exclusive music for $200 but it took you 2 hours to make the beat, 1 hour to mix, and 1 hour to create marketing materials. Overall, you spent 4 hours creating the product. Then, you have to spend time marketing. Let's add another 6 hours. That's a total of 10 hours. Even if you sell the exclusive for full price, $200, you spent 10 hours to do so. $200/10 HRS equals $20/HR. The problem isn't that you're only making $20/HR, the bigger problem is that you now have to spend all that time again to create the same results. Whenever you sell something exclusively or work in exchange for Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com page 83 time, you are limiting your results. The goal should be to systematize and get away from spending your time or hire someone to spend their time, so you can keep yours. The biggest secret in corporate America is that they're not buying supplies and goods, they're buying time from their employees, the greatest asset on the planet. The companies who buy the most time are the wealthiest. Whether they do this by hiring employees or leveraging automated systems, the game is to buy time. What's your return on time spent? Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com page 84. Solve problems or spike good feelings. The main goal for humans is to get from point A to point B the fastest. This is called taking the path of least resistance. Humans want to perfect creation so that there is no resistance between point A and point B. Resistance is anything which blocks your path or holds you back and slows you down while getting to your goal. You can either be the person to remove obstacles and resistance from someone's path, or you can make people feel good along the way from point A to point B, but keeping the existing resistance. The ideal business would completely remove all the obstacles between point A and point B, but we all know society is designed to keep the resistance and make people focus on solving the symptoms. Because if they can fool people to only solve for the symptoms, they can charge you more overtime due to no one addressing the Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com page 85. Root cause. It's like finding a weed in the garden and only chopping off the top portion. The weed will grow back again. To fully rid the weed, we must pull up the roots, aka solve the underlying cause. You can choose whether you want to transform people's lives for the better or just collect coins by stimulating people's happy button. It's not what you think, lol. What's the difference between solving problems and spiking good feelings? Solving problems means you fully remove resistance and obstacles in the path from point A to point B. This could be teaching someone how to patch a hole in the boat so they can safely and confidently row the boat from the shoreline to the island, without having to turn around due to the boat filling up constantly. Spiking good feelings would be gamifying their journey to the island from the shoreline, including the gamification of the bound to be hole in the boat. In this case, you would create an electric tracker which tracked the rows of the boat. When the user Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com page 86 hit 20 rows, they'd get a reward, whether physical or digital. And solving the hole in the boat would unlock other rewards. Solely aiming to spike good feelings does not have intent around truly solving the problem to create a sustainable solution. The goal would be to capitalize on all the rewardable moments. I like to solve problems because the release of the obstacle and resistance creates a natural internal reward. It's like when you're avoiding an emotional event, have to face it, and when you overcome the event you feel better than before. I'd rather receive the fruits of others when they feel the pleasure of solving a problem than keeping them stuck in their obstacles. Just keep in mind, if you plan to solve problems, not everyone truly wants their problems solved. Understand, they have to be willing and have a high desire to take action to truly cure or solve someone's problems. If you identify with solving people's problems and they don't take action on your guidance, it can cause the opposite emotional effect for you. It can make you feel sad because they're not changing. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com page 87. Their life for the better. It's up to you which path you choose. The hidden values, lording, status, and goals, etc. Many people think money itself is valuable and that can be argued. My main mission for this section is to teach you the invisible things people are buying from you. Always remember, people are not buying your thing. They are buying their desired outcomes, goals, and your thing is just a means to get there. They don't care about the thing but what it brings them closer to. There are a few hidden values when creating your products. I call these intangibles. A Rolex and G-Shock could use the same materials and supplies, but the Rolex could sell for 1,000 times more. Why? A Yeezy shoe and a Skecher could use the same materials and Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com page 88 supplies, but the Yeezy sell for 100 times the price. Why? It's because people aren't buying the thing, they are buying the intangibles. When you buy that Rolex, you are actually buying the ability to lord it over others to make you feel more superior and dominant. When you flash that Rolex watch, you are showing everyone of your social and economic status and class. People are not buying the thing, they are buying the end goal, the desired outcome. A man going into a Ferrari dealership is not going to buy a Ferrari because it has 800 HP, authentic Italian leather seats, and supreme metal quality. He is buying the Ferrari to prove to others that he has excess income to waste, in the hundreds of thousands. This shows a woman that he is a stable and financially secure mate because he has displayed a wealth signal to her. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 89. So, the man is not buying just the Ferrari, he's buying the potential to attract a mate. Why would he care about attracting a mate so bad? Because the first biblical commandment to mankind is to be fruitful and multiply. It's built into our DNA to want to survive. And by survive, I don't just mean live until tomorrow, I mean the survival of your genetics through your progeny, children, and the many generations to come. Survival is something beyond the lifetime of the man. He's aiming for his genetics to exist for thousands of years, not just until he passes on. He's not just buying the Ferrari, he's buying a competitive advantage to mate with another woman to continue his genetics for survival through multiple generations. These are intangibles. The more you understand what your customer is actually buying, the better you can communicate your value. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 90. If I was selling hair bundles to women, I know that most customers could care less about the hair source, hair texture, and hair quality. They just want to buy confidence by having a full head of hair they can use to audition for a mate to project their fitness. It all leads back to biology at the end of the day. Intangibles are the powerful subconscious drivers of action we take daily. Understand the intangibles and you will never worry about the thing you sell again. What are the intangibles for your brand association? What are the intangibles for your service offering? What are the intangibles for your product/product line? Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 91. How to find the value. Value is not the same for everyone, and knowing that fact is the key. If you want to mine the values of your market, you have to understand firstly that it will change based on who you ask. In other words, a hype beast may be willing to pay up to $2,000 for some rare Yeezy sneakers, but an Olympic gymnast may only value the sneakers at a max $100. Why is this? The phenomenon of value is amazing because it reinforces the idea that we all live in a consensual universe. Consensus is when everyone agrees on the same thing. You and I can agree that a rare vase is special and worth $300 minimum. You may think the vase is valuable and worth $2,000 and that I'm a fool for thinking it's only worth $300 maximum. But, we both agree that it's worth at least $300. That's consensus and that's how we price things in the market. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 92. If you were unaware of how stocks go up and down in price, it's simple. Estimated value. Stock prices. Seller A thinks their stock is worth $250. Seller B thinks their stock is worth $220. Buyer A thinks the stocks are overpriced. Buyer B thinks the stock is worth max $230. One buyer, two sellers, low demand slash high supply in this case. Buyer B has the option to purchase from both sellers. People don't know that stocks are sold at different prices regardless of what the price reads on apps. Buyer B will most likely purchase from seller B because he thinks the stock is of higher value and will exchange his money. However, buyer B thinks seller A is charging too much. He believes he's busy. Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 93. Exchanging his lesser valued money slash cash for a higher valued asset, the stock. Buyer A doesn't buy from either seller. This leaves seller A holding the stock and buyer B holding the same stock. Now, seller A holds stock and thinks it's worth $250. Buyer B holds stock and thinks it's worth $220, but there are no more buyers. So, in order to sell and make money, both seller A and buyer B have to lower the price of the stock until buyer A thinks it's ideal to buy. But what price is that? Seller A and buyer B decide to lower the price to $100 and buyer A buys from both sellers. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 94. The point to all this is to show you that we all value things differently. Using this example, they all agreed that the stock price was valued at $100 plus, but not everyone thought it was worth $230, so this describes one form of value discovery, estimated value. This form of value analysis is based on what we think something will be worth in the future. We're just estimating. Things we use value estimating on: stocks/futures, crypto, houses, rare items. This form of value is solely based on human psychology and the foundation of supply and demand. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 95. There are cryptocurrency projects that aren't backed by anything but human hype, just pure marketing. There is another form of value called utility. Utility value is when people find something useful and purposeful. It's like when you play Minecraft and craft an axe. You can use the axe to chop trees down. There's a purpose for the axe. However, when you harvest a poisonous potato, there is no use for it, except to make your Minecraft character lose health, and who really wants that, lol? With this form of value, people ask what they can do with your thing. It becomes your job to demonstrate what your thing can do for them. That's the whole point. Most people forget to demonstrate their product, and without demonstration, we assume our buyers are buying off of estimated value, what the price will be in the future. And 90% of the time, Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 96, we're not selling based on estimated value, unless you create real scarcity and supply limits. Chapter 3, Relationships override all other forms of marketing. Why? Because people buy from people and people control the world. You know that album that you would sell your house to be on? The album that you've been training 10 years straight for? Well, the rapper's cousin got on the album with his mediocre beat-making skills because he knew the rapper for 12 plus years and earned trust with him over that time. Relationships beat out money, time spent, effort, skill, talent, marketing tactics, years of schooling, luck, and mostly everything. At the end of the day, relationships are the most sacred because most decisions require a human. Humans are created for relationships with other humans. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 97. How do you build meaningful relationships without forcing it? Offer value when you meet new people. The biggest mistake producers and artists make when building their network is that they lead with no value. Who wants to be around people who add nothing to their life? I want people around me who offer opportunities, information, connections, something. Make sure that every person you meet, you find three ways to add value before you continue the relationship. You can do this simply by asking them for three obstacles in their way right now. Now, you may be asking, how do I offer value to millionaires? You do this by finding the solution for them, within your new network. In other words, you don't have to have the Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 98 solution, you have to point them to the person who does have the solution. That's the key. What is relationship? Relation, connectionship, quality/power/skill. Relationship quite literally means a connection that is of quality, a connection that is powerful, a connection based on skill, set. We connect with others based on many things, but most all relationships are formed based on a common interest. Take a look at all your friends. There is one common denominator between you and them. You could have a sports friend, a video games friend, a going out friend. But when you stop participating in those activities, you'll find that your friendship sizzles to an end. Why? Because most all relationships are based on common interests. When you meet new people, make it your goal to find common. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 99. Interests. Doing this will activate the enthusiasm in the other person and will bond you quicker than ever. And don't forget to add value to them by solving their problems. Introduce them to the graphic designer you know who can create the logo they need. Send them the article you just read about cryptocurrency since they were so interested to learn. Tell them about fun experiences in the city if they're not familiar. All these things are valuable. The one catch to relationship building is that you need to understand the politics. People like people and people don't like people. People who don't like each other usually don't have around each other or associate with one another, and if you try to merge the two parties you could find more resistance than you expected. Always keep in mind how people rank themselves. Most businesses have a social hierarchy, and if you make someone at the bottom of the ladder more important than those at the top, you could be met with resistance. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 100. Something I learned from Eben Pagan is that when you place A players with C players, the A players become C players. In other words, people who are talented want to be separated and honored as such. The same way LeBron probably doesn't want to play on the same team as a high school amateur player. What not to do when building relationships. I'll keep this section short and just write a long list of what not to do if you plan to keep your brand and respect while building relationships. Ask for anything up front. Go behind the back of the person who introduced you to another contact. Expect for the other person to act first. Act like you're affiliated off the first meeting. Use their name as leverage, likeness, without them knowing. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 101. Introduce your new contacts to bad contacts, bad reputation, get mad when they don't respond / offer opportunities, you have to earn this, drain the other person for information. Everything is a trade, bring value, reveal secrets from other contacts, this shows you can't hold private information, share business plans with competitors asking for favors too earlier or without first sowing favors, overextend yourself when there's no reciprocity, bring nothing to the deal table, bring known competitors together unless for conflict resolution, attack others for their perspective, work with someone that your ally despises. How to build new relationships. The fastest and easiest way to build relationships is finding common ground. If you don't know what the other person is busy, Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 102 interested in, just ask them, what are you into? What gets you excited? I ask that all the time. Watch that person light up like a lamp. People love talking about what they love. It's that simple. And, if you find any common interest, you can elaborate. Just let them finish, never cut them off. Even if I don't do the same exact activity as the person, I may insert an anecdote, story, about someone I know who is into that given activity. Or I will tell them about information I heard and ask them to explain more about the topic. That's it. People bond over commonalities. You made friends in school because you both went to the same school. You made friends bowling because you both like bowling. It's not complicated. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 103. Events are a great way to find like-minded individuals, but I've seen so many people make a huge mistake while attending events. First, let's start with the host's agenda. The host of an event is aiming to make their money back that they put down on the event. They are stressed. LOL and not worried about remembering your name. Secondly, events are not your golden ticket to become automatic friends with the host. It's simply an introduction. You don't get married when you first meet your spouse, do you? Now, let's look at it from a guest speaker's point of view, someone the host hired as talent. Most events have one host company and special guests which were brought in to add value to the event. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 104. The host's aim is to make their money back and use the event to meet the special guests, sometimes for the first time. The special guest's aim is to deliver on the expectations of the host to make sure they get paid and don't leave a bad impression, lol. The special guests also aim to meet the host and other special guests. Lastly, let's take a look from the attendee's point of view. The attendee usually wants everything: to meet new people in the industry, to become best friends with the host, and to get known worldwide because they played your song from the DJ stand during the 1HR song feedback. I get it. The real goal of the attendee should be to focus on the other attendees and create a horizontal network. Just remain humble and don't always go after the big guy, unless, and I say unless you have massive value to offer. I'm not just talking about beat making skills. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 105. One surefire way to be remembered by the host is to bring something to the table, deals. If your host is a big producer, bring melody loops or display your sound design skills. If your host is an executive, be ready to make introductions to another big player in the field. It's that simple. Most people think that they have to be the one with all the value. No. Sometimes, all you need to do is introduce the person with the problem to the person with the solution. Common interests. I will keep this short because I already showed you how to bond with people near instantly. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 106. I will speak in generalities to make this simple. Entrepreneurs want to be among other entrepreneurs and experts of the industry. Beat makers bond over rare drum and synth sounds. Musicians unite over shared great performances and gig life. In other words, birds of a feather flock together. I think I made that up, or Gandhi or somebody. LOLJK. You won't find the church girl at the local dive bar, and you won't find the bodybuilding guy in Sephora, unless his girl dragged him there. Smiley face. Environments signal interest and people bond over common interest. It's that simple, don't make it any more complicated than that. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 107. Value add. If you want to leave a lasting impression on someone, instead of asking them what they can do for you, ask them how you can add value to them. Ask them their three biggest obstacles they're solving for at the moment. Asking too vague of a question is just as bad as asking for something. Simply asking "what can I help you with" seems more like a leech question than someone who actually has solutions ready. Add value before you ask for anything, and add value way before you remotely think you've gained rapport with the other person. And, don't do it expecting anything. It's that tit-for-tat mentality that leaves people in the dust when it comes to relationship building. People will always repay someone who gave out of pure intent. People who have the intent to get something back are actually approaching with a leech mentality. I will give him something to force him to give me something in return. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 108. Who wants to be manipulated? Nobody, exactly. Now, if you're approaching someone to trade and have legitimate business to handle, then so be it. But, you don't have to act like you're giving gifts. If you have no skills or resources to give, then connect the people who do to the person you want to build with. Be the connector. Touch points. In these times, not only is everything going digital, but we're under constraints we've never seen before in human history. People don't want to go out and be touchy-feely because it can harm themselves and their family. So, we solve this by creating virtual touch points. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 109. A touchpoint is the idea of creating a stronger bond, full of trust, by touching someone. Touching someone is known to release oxytocin, which is the bonding chemical. It's the chemical that a mother of a child shares with the child she carries during pregnancy. It creates a love bond between mother and child. It's that strong. Hugging, giving dap, handshakes, touching shoulders, and other mannerisms release that chemical while you're building new relationships. That's all well and good, but during these times, people don't necessarily want to be touched, and for good reason. So, how do we solve this? Let me start by explaining. The reason you love your parents is because you saw them the most. You were served the most impressions of them, and it created a bond. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 110. Our goal is to create touch points with new contacts by showing up in their lives digitally, but not to the point where it's annoying. You want to have multiple touch points because people's attention wanes throughout the day and they may be active on 3+ social platforms per day. You will need to show up on all of those platforms and create touch points. It doesn't mean DM them to tears lol. It means you need to be seen by them over and over to increase the number of impressions you have on their subconscious mind. You will build familiarity without even talking to them. Do not aim to impress and show out, just be seen. Signs of desperation show that someone is most likely a leech that doesn't have much going on for themselves. Your goal is not to suck up to these people or overly praise them, it's simply to be seen. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 111. Building trust currency. Trust is the actual currency we trade with at high levels. No one has the time to do the research. No one has the time to do background checks when you're meeting someone for the first time. We rely on trust. Trust is the currency. It's better than money. People who make money and have their own income streams aren't moved by money. They are moved by trust. Your likeness, your perception in the market, your reputation, your social standing, your goodwill in the market, your past accomplishments, your business partners are your currency. When people come to me and start asking about money right away, I know that they will be a problem and I tend to not work with them. People who make money understand that money is a result of the work they do. A salesman understands that the results are based on what he sells. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 112. Unless you're inquiring about the due diligence on a deal, numbers should not be discussed unless you're very comfortable with someone. Again, it's not that money shouldn't be talked about, it's just that people who always ask about the money and how much they'll be paid on the first meeting are the ones who usually become problematic. Again, there are exceptions like a meeting to hire someone lol, but I'm talking about just meeting someone you wish to build a relationship with and network with. You don't meet a girl you want to date and immediately start talking about sleeping with her. Not because she'll be turned off, but you haven't created perceived value, there wasn't enough time. Marketing is the practice of increasing value over a period of time. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 113. Sales is when you close or complete or extract the value once you've established the value through marketing. Promotion is when you keep showing up in someone's life and talking about your thing, this doesn't necessarily increase your value. Branding is when your marketing holds its value. Advertising is about understanding the threshold of value you're willing to accept to complete a deal. The goal of meeting someone is to initiate the process of increasing your value in their eyes, not to sell them right away. Introductions: if you skip everything else in this book and just read this, you're good to go. Introductions. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 114. The greatest skill I've ever learned, which led me to exponential growth, is the art of the introduction. As mentioned above, people at higher levels operate on trust. What that means is how you are introduced will determine if you get a deal or not. I'm not talking about just record deals. Who introduces you to key players? That matters. The person who introduces you has to have a solid reputation. You can be the dopest of dope, but if you're introduced by a competitor or someone with a poor reputation, it can kill all progress in that future relationship. Good news is that being introduced by high-level people stamps you. Think about how royal families used to knight their soldiers. The knighting process was a public demonstration of the passing on of trust. The royal would place a sword, symbolic of trust, on the shoulder of a knight and pass on trust to that knight. So, all the love people had for the king and queen was passed on to that knight. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 115. The knight could have been a nobody the day before, but because he was introduced by royalty, people with trust, he benefited from that current of trust. Okay, but game, I don't know anybody famous who can put me on. My answer to you is that it's now your job to make introductions. Instead of delivering products as value to someone, deliver important people. Introduce the producer who hosted that event to an IP lawyer who can help them. Introduce that business owner with an NFT expert you met on Clubhouse. Introduce that producer to your talented musician friends who can make custom loops. Your first thought when meeting anyone is to think who you can connect them with. This will magnify the value you offer them by a minimum of 10. Busy Signal BusyWorksBeats.com page 116. And the best part is that you don't have to be a genius, you just have to know people. It's that easy. Introduce people to other people. That is extremely valuable. Facebook made a whole business around connecting buyers to sellers. You can do the same thing. Make the introduction. Know a girl that would be perfect for that single guy who owns a company, introduce her to him. Know an executive who needs influencers, introduce them to the key player. Just make the introduction. Keeping it alive, okay, you made the connection. You impressed and wooed the clients, now what? This is the problem with most people teaching you how to be confident, how to pick up girls, lol, it's that they never show you the skills to keep people. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 117. They will show you all the easy ways to get people's attention and benefit in the beginning, but no one shows you the long game. I've been in business over 6 years and I'm still growing and serving the producer community, it's just the beginning. This is a long game. If I broke my integrity, my audience wouldn't trust me to listen. If I milked my audience for every cent, they wouldn't be filled with energy to give. If I clickbaited and edited my way to fame, no one would truly respect me. It's about the long game. How do you keep a relationship alive over time, even when going through the rough patches? It is all about perspective, and a couple psychology tricks, lol. I've been talking about music theory for over 5 years, I think, lol, there's only one way to make a chord. It's not complicated. What's complicated is making people enjoy learning the same thing over. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 118, and over again. Instead of how to make a minor chord, you have to think of ways to flip it. Add celebrity, how to make dark minor chords like TM88, use urgency, breaking Metro Boomin uses the secret chord, introduce novelty, new chord for trap beats will blow you away. These are the types of videos I create. They are based on the same principle. What changes is the way I present the material. It's like wearing a new outfit every day when you go to see your girl. Keeping things alive is not about changing the core thing, it's about presenting it from a different angle. Metaphorically, add a filter to your perspectives. Look at the same thing in different ways. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 119. Keeping relationships alive is about being authentic, delivering real value, not wasting words, and being seen over and over again. When to ask favors, most people ask for favors way before they're justified. I will give you a quick list of when and how to ask for favors. 1. Ask only after you've delivered value to the other person of interest, after all, you wanted their attention. 2. Ask after you get them to say yes to smaller, easier things. 3. Ask them months in advance, do not put pressure on people to help you because you weren't prepared. People need time to organize their power, you can't just spring up asking for random favors. 4. Ask after you do a favor for them, meaning you didn't charge for the service/value exchange, to do a favor in return in the future. 5. Ask when the favor will also make them look good in the eyes of their audience or your audience. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 120. How to ask for favors. Most people don't have the leverage to ask for favors. Think of a favor like a voucher you can redeem. If you never did anything to earn the voucher, why would you expect to use it to get something for free? Don't confuse favors with trades of value, bartering. Bartering is when you exchange equal or greater value in exchange for something someone else has to offer. That's not asking for a favor. So how do you ask for favors? 1. Schedule a meeting or quick call. Asking over DM has no tone, and if you don't have a great existing relationship, it seems insincere. 2. Give them a story. If you share this, I will do this, in the future, not a direct trade. Think of this like using relationship credit. 3. Name drop the people who already have trust. If a person thinks doing the favor will score them trust points with the people. Busy Signal, BusyWorksBeats.com, page 121. Who have high levels of trust, it's an easier ask. The person with a good reputation is like a co-signer, using their trust credit. 4. Don't call it a favor. 5. Say, is there anyway? Symbiotic relationships in nature, there's a balance of all things. A yin and a yang. Productive relationships have dual benefits, not just a one-sided benefit. One-sided benefit is called leeching, lol. A two-way benefit is called a symbiotic relationship. Each person has a need that the other fulfills. It's that simple. Just aim to deliver on people's needs, and in return, you can expect them to reciprocate to fill your needs. If you're continuing to pour into someone who doesn't reciprocate, that's your decision. Don't get mad at them when you choose to busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 122. Keep pouring your all into something that won't give you a return on your investment. That's like continuously dumping your money into a stock that goes nowhere but down. Don't keep buying the dip if it keeps dipping. Yeah, dip lol. Leech relationships, simple. Leech relationships are one-sided relationships. One person gets their needs met, the other doesn't. Simple. Don't be a leech. When you can't find ways to add value to someone else, it doesn't make you a leech. A leech relationship is when the intent of the leech is for sole benefit at the expense of someone else. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 123. Communication level expectations. I learned quickly with my new business partner that there are levels of communication. I'll keep this section short because I'm just trying to finish this book. LOL. People you just meet, match their frequency, until you find their rhythm. People you know a bit, communicate when you have something to offer. You don't want to create resistance by overly talking about nothingness. People who like you for real, communicate monthly with responses to things they create. Only approach them when you have something of value. No wasted calls/meetings. People on a partnership level, communication has to be your religion. You have to eat, sleep, and breathe communication. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 124. Communication is your radar in the business field. It's how you know the enemies are flanking, so you can get ready and prepare. It is how you create chains of action and understand the intent behind the action. Everything is communication on the partner level. There is no such thing as too much communication, unless it hinders an important action which benefits the partnership. Access and levels, boundaries based on contact. A huge mistake beginners in business make is giving people too much access. You may think being easily accessible is good for growing your audience and being present for clients. Being too accessible is actually one of the easiest ways to slow your business. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 125. If anyone can pull your attention at any time, you have no control over your time and attention. My method is simple. Give family and close contacts my mobile number. Give business acquaintances, who want to do real business, my personal email. Give companies who want to inquire about other business dealings my business email. Give my audience who want to inquire about orders my business email. Give the general audience the ability to comment. I turned off my IG DMs because people think they can just text you like they have your number. You need to create boundaries around your access and your time. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 126. You need to set the rules of how your audience engages with you. It's not just a pompous thing. It's because the more time you spend with someone who's just bored and doesn't want to do any business at all, because you didn't qualify them in conversation, the more time you lose with real customers who have real issues. Customers come first in business because they give you money. If you're wasting your time replying to people who just want to be social on social media, you are literally costing your company hundreds of dollars. Unless you have millions to blow, this is a cardinal sin of business. That's why I don't go back and forth and back and forth with people messaging me. I have questions that are designed to get people to the point and sort them to reduce the amount of touches I have to make to an inquiry. If too many people have access to you, you become the bottleneck in your business flow. You're only one person trying to answer 200 people. That's a recipe for chaos. Busy signal busyworkspeeds.com page 127. Scaling is about reducing redundancy and creating systems which prevent bottlenecks when growing, and this is the number one place I see people make huge mistakes, costing them big when they attempt to grow. Nothing is worse than having unmanageable messaging. Create boundaries. Everyone does not deserve your time and access. Final words. All right, that's enough for now. Maybe when I get inspired again, I'll write more and go deeper into other concepts, but for now, I'm tired, smiley face. And special thank you to Courtney for showing me how to finish this book. This book wouldn't have been completed without her insights. Game, busyworksbeats.com. 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 Busyworksbeats.com.